BOSU friends and vlog viewers. I'm Lawrence Piscantini, BOSU Master Trainer and Development Team Specialist, with Bernadette O'Brien, also our oldest BOSU Master Trainer and Development Team Specialist, here to talk about some of the lesser publicized intrinsic benefits of just starting to move and get well. So many people, you know, Betty, start to work with trainers and they measure their circumference and they do these assessments and it's all about the numbers. You started with some dramatic changes in the last couple of years and you had really changes from the inside happen that started promoting you to continue to work even better, right?
Yes, correct.
So tell me about your weight loss.
Well, my weight loss was dramatic. I lost approximately 65 pounds in 2 years.
Of
fat, Lawrence. And you were the instrument behind that because it was your training with the BOSU that allowed me and permitted me to lose that kind of weight.
And we'll tell your whole story in another one of our BOSU blogs, because we're going to tell people who are interested in how you started changing from aqua to land and how this half blue vinyl bladder ball made in Ohio really changed your life in that way. So intrinsically, or not measurable issues, what started happening when you started to make some movement changes, moving more, correctly eating, finding out what healthy eating meant? What was one of the first things that you noticed changed?
But one of the first things, Lawrence, was that I slept better. I was able to sleep 7 hours straight through at night, and that was unheard of because I would twist and turn and wake up, and that disappeared.
And was that with or without wine?
That was without wine, Lawrence.
Okay, so you started sleeping better, and then if you sleep better, you noticed that during the day you had more energy to put
Absolutely.
Back into your movement.
And it improved my balance. And that was very important because one of the instruments we were using was a BOSU, and balance is something you work on the BOSU.
Right, and for those who can't imagine what you look like, we'll show you. But when you were much, much heavier, looking down wasn't so easy because you weren't always able to stand tall and see your toes. So going forward, if your number one fear as you age is a fear of
falling
and not being able to see your feet, that must be pretty incredibly uplifting when all of a sudden you look down and could see your knees and feet and where you're moving in forward in space and time. And that's all about confidence. And there's this word we use called self-efficacy, where we increase your confidence, another intrinsic gain. What does self-efficacy mean?
Self-efficacy means that when you wake up in the morning, you have the confidence to do anything you have decided to do that day alone. It's empowerment. And that was one of the most wonderful things that occurred as a result of losing the weight, exercise, or doing movement with the BOSU.
Okay, so you started to do, your life was half in New Jersey in the summers, and then your other half was, you're a snowbird, you leave the snow and go to Puerto Rico, and basically you live in a spa, your condo is right attached to a spa for half a year, right?
Correct.
And how did your self-confidence, another intrinsic goal, change as you started to lose weight and move more?
Well, you know, Lawrence, when you go to a spa, there's a communal dressing room, there's a wonderful whirlpool where you take off your bathing suit and you go into that and enjoy it. Well, when you're very heavy, that's not very comforting to be on view for everybody to see.
Right.
So it helped my self-confidence, it helped my ego, it made me feel so much better about myself to be able to recognize the changes and enjoy what had happened to my body.
And at spas, you also get massages, right? Don't you take your clothes off
yes.
for a total stranger and say, rub me with hot oil?
Yes, you do, Lawrence.
So you didn't do that years ago, and then all of a sudden, in addition to getting the hot club or hot tub with confidence, you started to book more massages, didn't
Absolutely.
You?
Absolutely.
Well, that all takes money. So somehow that money's going to come from somewhere, forgetting the fact that your population, people over 60, 70, and 80, and yes, Bernadette O'Brien is over 80, actually have more disposable income than, say, teaching teens or training adolescents or yuppies. So tell me this, where does that money come from? You actually found some intrinsic, lesser publicized ways that you were saving money. So you used to have some disease, right?
I had type 2 diabetes, but it was reversed. And not everyone can reverse it. According to the doctors, once you have it, you generally have it for life.
Right.
However, the type I had was because fat had accumulated around the pancreas.
Midsection.
Yes. And it prevented the pancreas from functioning properly. But when you lost the weight, then the pancreas began to work the way it should, And how did I save money? In one way was I didn't need the medications, and the medications are rather costly.
Right, they're costly. So what did you do? What was the first thing you bought for yourself when you had all this money because you got the note that you reversed diabetes?
A trip to Bali.
Right, you went to Bali, and that was part of your training, but before you even went to Bali, you bought something for your fitness and movement routine, didn't you?
I bought a BOSU.
You had always trained on one.
And a soft training ball.
I bought
both things because they were required for the wonderful exercises that I had in store for me.
We did movements.
We did movement.
Right. So then also, how were you feeling in general as you started to move more using the BOSU Balance Trainer? Something you can't measure. I could ask you, what are your weight today? And I never weigh you. And I take your body fat percentage, and I never did. And I could take your body hip to circumference, and I never did those. Obviously, I don't even know how to say them. I'm not into assessments and circumference. Did I ever take a tape measure to you?
Not at all.
No. Did I ever put you on a scale?
Never.
In fact, what was one of the goals and one of the commitments and agreements? You would never?
I wouldn't use the weight as a measurement, but I did measure myself.
And by clothes, how they were fitting,
exactly.
And more importantly, intrinsically, how you were.
I felt lighter. I felt energetic. I felt able. I felt in control of what I wanted to do and could do.
Right. So after a year and a half of losing 65 pounds of fat, walking around must feel dramatically different.
Dramatically different, because you can get to where you want to go without too much trouble. So that is a great bonus, to be able to move with agility and be able to function and feel good.
And getting in and out of a car, right? Or as stepping over the tub, all the things that were before very laborious for you, all of a sudden now with confidence and self-efficacy and feeling lighter, you're able to do all this while saving money at the same time?
Yes.
Seems like a plan to me. So talking about saving money, you did put some money into your footwear, which was really kind of unique because you were always told as you were diabetic, tell us a little bit about the feet.
Well, with the feet, you had to wear a shoe or a sneaker and socks in order to protect your feet. You never wanted to get a cut because it might not heal. And so you were always very cautious about the care of your feet.
As a diabetic.
I guess everybody should be a little careful, but primarily as a diabetic. And so, as the reversal occurred, I was then able to wear minimalist shoes, such as these Vibrams.
Right.
And because they simulate being barefoot, so
right.
That was the first step.
Right.
And then I actually was able to do classes and movement in bare feet, which is the best way to do movements if it's available to you.
Right, and now you teach land classes where you fuse some ancient disciplines and you call it ancient disciplines, and everyone's barefoot, right?
Correct.
If there are special populations, do you have any diabetics who have to keep their shoes on?
Oh, definitely. I have lots of people with special issues that are diabetic in the classroom and other things that they have to watch out.
I remember when you first got the Vibrams, you said, it's definitely a learning curve, bending over to put them on, but bending over to put shoes on is such a joy now, Lawrence, compared to the past. Can you tell us a little bit about that? Because when you lose all of this, the simplest thing that we take for granted, a very intrinsic hindrance, became how for you?
Yes, I can even cut my own toenails.
And the things that you couldn't do before.
Absolutely. Being able to bend, touch the floor, that not only are you touching the floor in the movement, but that's very functional activity to be able to pick up things, to be able to pick up your grandchild, your luggage. All of those things require bending over.
Or just putting on your shoes.
Or just putting on your shoes.
So those are about 6 intrinsic goals that change when you start to move more and learn what healthy eating really means. Definitely my inspiration on the planet, Bernadette O'Brien, how she's actually incorporated the BOSU Balance Trainer with just 4 key moves in another BOSU blog coming up elsewhere. But I just want to share this with you because little known thoughts that we always forget to take advantage of telling to our classes and clients that occur. Fitness from the inside out. And that's really what the half ball, not the whole ball, the BOSU Balance Trainer helped bring out of you when you started to get out of aqua classes and do stuff on land. My inspiration, Bernadette O'Brien. Thanks for joining me.